Hello. In the previous series, we talked about the accounting cycle. And now we will be with a new series in which we will talk about the financial statements. Today, our topic is the income statement and the statement of retained earnings. But wait. If you are new to my channel, please give me a like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Are you ready? Let's begin. An income statement is one of the three important financial statements used for reporting a company's financial performance over a specific accounting period, with the other two key statements being the balance sheet and the statement of cash flows, also known as the profit and loss statement or the statement of revenue and expense. The income statement primarily focuses on the company's revenues and expenses during a particular period. Elements of the income statement: revenues, expenses, gains, losses. Revenues, inflows or other enhancements of assets or settlements of liabilities that constitute the entity's ongoing major or central operations. Examples of revenues: accounts, sales, fee, interest, dividend, rent. Expenses, outflows or other using up of assets or incurrences of liabilities that constitute the entity's ongoing major or central operations. Examples of expense accounts: cost of goods sold, depreciation, interest, rent, salaries and wages, taxes. Gains, increase in equity, net assets from peripheral or incidental transactions. Losses, decrease in equity, net assets from peripheral or incidental transactions. Gains and losses can result from sale of investments or plant assets, settlement of liabilities, write-offs of assets. What's a single-step income statement? A single-step income statement presents the revenues, expenses, and ultimately the profit or loss generated by a business. But it reports on this information by using just one equation to calculate profits. The equation used in a single-step income statement is net income equals revenues plus gains minus expenses plus losses. The single-step income statement offers a straightforward accounting of the financial activity of your business. It's easy to understand and relatively easy to prepare. As you can see here, we have revenues and expenses, and the residual is the net income. What's a multi-step income statement? A multi-step income statement reports much of the same general information included in a single-step income statement, but uses multiple equations to determine the net income or profit of the company. The multi-step income statement breaks down operating revenues and operating expenses versus non-operating revenues and non-operating expenses. This separates revenues and expenses that are directly related to the business's operations from those that are not directly tied to its operations. The multi-step income statement uses three or four different accounting formulas to arrive at the net income. Number one, gross profit equals net sales minus cost of goods sold. Number two, income from operations equals gross profit minus operating expenses. Operating expenses are selling expenses and administrative expenses. Income before income tax equals operating income plus non-operating items. Net income equals income before income tax minus income tax. Still a bit unclear? Don't worry. We have an example at the end of this topic. How can we report various income items? Discontinued operations occurs when company eliminates the results of operations of a component of the business and there is no significant involvement in that component after the disposal transaction. Amounts reported net of tax. Illustration: KC Product Incorporated, a highly diversified company, decides to discontinue its electronics division. During the current year, the electronics division lost $300,000 net of tax. KC Products sold the division at the end of the year at a loss of $500,000 net of tax. Show how the discontinued operations would be reported on the income statement for KC Products. We have income from continuing operations $20 million. Discontinued operations. We have loss from operations net of tax $300,000. Loss on disposal net of tax $500,000. Total loss on discontinued operations $800,000. And the net income is $19,200,000. Extraordinary items. Extraordinary items are non-recurring material items that differ significantly from a company's typical business activities. Extraordinary items must meet both of the following criteria: unusual nature and infrequently of occurrence. Company must consider the environment in which operates. Amount reported net of tax. Extraordinary gains. Illustration. Schindler Co. has income before income tax and extraordinary item of $250,000. It has an extraordinary gain of $100,000 from a condemnation settlement received on one of its properties. 30% tax rate. The income statement presentation looks like that. Here we have income before income tax and extraordinary item, $250,000. The income tax is 30% of $250,000. $75,000. $250,000 minus $75,000 equal income before extraordinary item of $175,000. Extraordinary gain, condemnation settlement, $100,000. We have to add net of applicable income tax. $100,000 times 30% equals $30,000, and the net is $70,000. The net income equals $175,000 plus $70,000 equals $245,000. If you want to speak about extraordinary losses, the same example, Schindler Co. has income before income tax and extraordinary item of $250,000. It suffers an extraordinary loss from a major casualty of $100,000, 30% tax rate. The loss provides a positive tax benefit. The income statement presentation looks like that. Income before extraordinary item, like the previous example, is $175,000. Extraordinary item, casualty loss, $100,000. It must be subtracted net of applicable income tax. $100,000 times 30% equals $30,000, and the net is $70,000. The net income equals $175,000 minus $70,000 equals $105,000. Earning per share equals net income minus preferred dividends divided by weighted average of common shares outstanding. It's considered as a significant business indicator, measures the dollars earned by each share of common stock, must be disclosed on the income statement. Here we have illustration. Lancer Incorporated reports net income of $350,000. Declares and pays preferred dividends of $50,000 for the year. The weighted average number of common shares outstanding during the year is 100,000 shares. Lancer computes earnings per share as follows. Net income minus preferred dividends divided by weighted average of common shares outstanding. $350,000 minus $50,000 divided by $100,000 equals 3 per share. As we can see here, all these figures divided by weighted average shares outstanding. Let's move to the comprehensive income. All changes in equity during a period except those resulting from investments by owners and distributions to owners, includes all revenues and gains, expenses and losses reported in net income, and all gains and losses that bypass net income but affect stockholders' equity. It's net income plus other comprehensive income. Unrealized gains and losses on available for sale securities, translation gains and losses on foreign currency, plus others. Companies must display the components of other comprehensive income in one of two ways: a single continuous statement, one statement approach, or two separate but consecutive statements of net income and other comprehensive income, two statement approach. Let's move to the example. Presented below are income statement items from Brown Company for the year ended December 31, 2021. And the instructions are: prepare a condensed multiple-step income statement and a comprehensive income statement. Assume a tax rate of 30% and 100,000 shares of common stock outstanding during 2021. After the header of the income statement, we'll start with the gross profit section. Here we have sales revenue, $2,070,000, minus cost of goods sold, $1,150,000. Then we have interest revenue, so we have to put other revenues and gains and other expenses and losses. We have interest revenue, $15,000, in other revenues and gains. Loss from abandonment of plant assets, $45,000, in other expenses and losses. Gain from extinguishment of debt, $28,000, in other revenues and gains. Unrealized holding loss on available for sale investments, net of tax, $12,000, in the comprehensive income statement. It's unrealized loss. It will be subtracted from the net income. Selling expenses and administrative expenses, we'll put them after the gross profit section. Loss from earthquake, unusual and infrequent, $30,000. It's an extraordinary item. We can put it like this: loss from earthquake, $30,000, less applicable income tax, $30,000 times 30% equals $9,000. Gain on disposal of component of Brown business, $50,000. It's discontinued operations. Like the previous one, we have to report it net of tax. Gain from disposal of component of business, $50,000. Less applicable income tax, $15,000. It's 30% of $50,000. Now let's complete the income statement. Sales revenue minus cost of goods sold equals gross profit. It's $1,550,000. Gross profit minus operating expenses, i.e. selling expenses and administration expenses, equal income from operations, $1,070,000. Income from operations plus other revenues and gains minus other expenses and losses equals income before income taxes, $1,068,000. Income tax equal $1,068,000 times 30% equals $320,400. Income before income taxes minus income tax equals income from continuing operations, $747,600. Income from continuing operations plus discontinued operations gains equal income before extraordinary items, $782,600. Income before extraordinary items minus extraordinary loss equals net income, $761,600. The net income is transferred to the statement of comprehensive income. Net income minus unrealized loss equals comprehensive income, $749,600. To complete the income statement, we must put earning per share, and we have to divide all these numbers by 100,000 shares. Let's start with income from continuing operations. divided by 100,000 shares equals $7.48. And then discontinued operations, it's 35 cents. Income before extraordinary item, $7.83. Less extraordinary item, net of tax, 21 cents. Net income, $7.61. What's the statement of retained earnings? The statement of retained earnings reconciles changes in the retained earnings accounts during a reporting period. It's useful for understanding how management utilizes the profit generated by a business. The statement begins with the beginning balance in the retained earnings account and then adds or subtracts such items as profits and dividends payment to arrive at the end retained earning balance. The general calculation structure of the statement is beginning retained earning plus net income minus dividends equal ending retained earnings. The retained earnings increase with net income, change in accounting principles, prior period adjustments, and decrease with net loss, dividends, change in accounting principles, prior period adjustments. Here we have an example. Eddie Zambrano Corporation began operations on January 1st, 2011. During its first 3 years of operations, Zambrano reported net income and declared dividends as follows. We have net income and dividends declared for the years 2011, 2012, and 2013. The following information relates to 2014. Income before income tax, $240,000. Prior period adjustment under statement of 2012 depreciation expense. Before taxes, $25,000. Cause it's an expense under statement, so we have to subtract it, net of tax. Cumulative decrease in income from change in inventory methods before taxes, $35,000. We have decrease in income, so we have to subtract the decrease, net of tax. Dividends declared, $100,000. We have to subtract it. Of the dividends declared to date, the amount will be paid on Jan 2015 is $25,000. It won't affect the statement because it will be paid in the next year. Instructions: prepare a 2014 retained earnings statement for Eddie Zambrano Corporation. Balance January 1 as reported. It's $40,000 plus $125,000 plus $160,000 minus $50,000 plus $50,000 equal $225,000 minus correction of depreciation error net of tax $10,000 tax. It's $15,000 minus cumulative decrease in income from change in inventory methods net of $14,000 tax. It's $21,000. And the result is balance January 1 as adjusted, $189,000. Add net income, it's $240,000 minus 40% tax equals $144,000. Less dividends declared, $100,000. And the balance on December 31 is $233,000. Here we come to the end of this video. Goodbye with another financial statement.